Right.
At level 2, if you have 1 point Gush and 1 point Anchor Smash, you're a very powerful tri-laner. So that could have been a Aura. It counted like he just had the bottle in the fountain, so
right.
he got a free refill, which is, I feel like it's a little bit stupid.
Well, you don't even
like
have
it.
To give the bottle anymore. You can just alt-click it or whatever it is, or control-click it.
Is that enough? Don't you need to pass it over?
I don't think so.
Oh, okay.
Because
the
Aura effect,
the
well, the Aura effect won't be on the hero that you're giving it to, so it won't refill.
Top lane MSS will be opening on God here. Vendetta into Impale. There is a TP in from Doom. Very easy kill going the way of Mouse. Let's see if they're going to have to trade for it, though.
Oh, Deny is going to come out for Brewmaster. Very nicely done. And it's going to run away as the support Brewmaster, level 4. Pycat not able to
He's
secure
actually
kill
coming
with
back
the
in.
He's going to come in.
Oh.
Thunderclap's going to miss just barely.
That would have been a kill.
Indeed, it would have. So 3-0 advantage for Mouse Sports. Of course, it really is 2 because of that Deny. Oh, nice Grave on Illidan. Going to save him at least for now. But the Thunderstrike might be enough to get the kill. Nice heal. Fata going to get the last hit here as some damage is going to come out from the tower. And actually, Astral Prism is going to be used on Dazzle as he TPs out. M's kinetic field and the static storm actually hitting it correctly. JOTM in all likelihood is dead. Fata, another astral imprisonment, this time on poor old Illidan, who is very aggressive for how close he is to dying here. Thunderstrike is going to give him vision. Fata, continue with the right clicks. Here comes another astral imprisonment, but Arsard is here to save the day. And this is a hero we haven't seen him play lately. What happened? What happened?
Oh, we'll get to that in a moment. The fight's continuing
okay.
here. Illidan.
Oh, Fata getting initiated on by AA. Right clicks are there. Illidan getting completely destroyed, though, to the right clicks overall. MSS and company going to turn on Arsard now. Can he get away with that Firefly? Spike Carapace, so good against Batrider, but the Grave is going to be there, at least for now. And he might actually live through this. Astral Imprisonment now turning on Dazzle. They're going to attempt to surround him. And actually, he doesn't even try to run away. Probably for the safety of the rest of his team, I suppose.
Yeah, so what happened in the top lane at the same time was Pycat was chasing down the Venno and did manage to ending in the Nature's Guise. Is there True Sight for Virtus Pro? There's True Sight at the back, but not really at the front. Oh, there it is.
Oh,
very
my.
Nice sentry placement here from John. They're going to see
Pop. Oh, he's going to get initiated by Arsard. And actually, that was the Eclipse used to completely demolish him. Panda Ult was also Pop, so they're going to right-click this tower down. Astral Imprisonment self-made on the Outworld Devourer. Arsart, though, taking the Sanity's Eclipse to the face. Spike Carapace is there as well. And Fata getting very low. Whirlwind
oh,
used
what a
on
clap.
Doom. Clap on 3 heroes. Misery's going to go down. In all likelihood, OD as well. As VP is cleaning up here at the bottom tower. Pycat resigned to try to get a last hit here on Arsart. Level death coming off cooldown in 1 second. But there is the Grave. So it doesn't even matter. 4 heroes down for Mouse.
Five.
In Virtus Pro's favor. Treant, did he...
Yeah,
I guess
Trent
okay.
died first,
wow,
and he even bought back.
Oh, he actually bought back. Yeah. Wow, okay.
Talk about a value sentry right there. That sentry MVP of the fight. Have to be smoked, and VP are just going to use the high ground advantage. This is a classic play from them, using positioning the way they should, and now they could be walking
oh,
into a trap
boy.
Here, Mouse.
Gale's going to hit 2. There's the Poison Nova, only hitting a couple of those. Statics on the follow. There's the ultimate from Illidan. He's going to get doomed right away. He's going to have to back up, not doing a whole lot of damage. Sandy's Eclipse not doing much damage either. It was on a couple of heroes that... Well, the only casualty here is Disruptor, surprisingly enough, and 2 big-time BKBs were used for Mouse. And the Doom as well. A lot was used for both teams, really.
Yeah, this
but
is a roach
Brewmaster
for
still has his ult, keep that in mind.
Yep, anyone on Mouse, easily. And it's not like Illidan's farm is amazing. He's got 100... Oh, wait
oh,
a second, nice
only
BKB!
Hit 1, beautiful BKB, but Illidan's Overgrowth finally being used. It's actually going to work on those Panda Spirits. There we see Whirlwind now on Doom. Hasn't got his actual Doom off yet because he's still spinning in the air. BKB is there. Doom, who is it on? Can't even see. Not sure who is on, but Misery's going to try to TP out.
There
finally,
is.
Doom is used on Illidan. He's going to try to right-click. Of course, he does have Aegis, so he doesn't really care if he goes down here. Everybody's so low for Mouse Wars. Tree is going to be the first dead. Follow-up from Arsar trying to get Fata, but the BKB, among other things, going to save him. Up, oh, Static. Nope.
Glimpse.
Okay.
Good Impale.
Into an Impale, but there's the Grave. Again, you're
Damn,
talking about this being used
so
several
valuable.
Times in a fight. Misery's going to go down to Luna. And the push continues for Virtus Pro. Are they shocking everybody today? They're playing out of their minds in the
Smoke
future.
Smoke behind the line. Arsart will be thinking about this. If he can catch Misery, that's going to be a really big pick. He will. Wow.
As he gets initiated on Misery, taking a lot of damage, but taking the Astral Spirit now. MSS very low, getting the Vendetta. The Flame Brick's going to kill him. I don't believe it. Overgrowth now on Pandas yet again. And Mouse Sports on the run, working from behind this whole game. Static Storm, among other things. Misery, they're just diving. Virtus Pro going... pretty much balls deep. Jotam now taking the Doom himself. He'll get glimpsed into a kinetic field. He might actually die for once, so the Doom might be doing something here. Sanity's Eclipse to follow. The
Just
only casualty
nothing.
Is Virtus Pro. I mean, if you have to Doom a Dazzle, that is not good news. Mouse Sports 2 dead. Virtus.Pro should be able to get this Rax with the DD still active in Illidan and the Aegis for another minute. This is two Rax down for Virtus.Pro, or in Virtus.Pro's favor, I should say.
Congratulations on your prediction. 3-0 Mal's going out the window after the first game. Very well predicted. Suns fan on the ball, as always. Great prediction.
The only reason I did this is because of you. Typical.
Yeah.
But right now, we have to be honest here. Virtus.Pro, they're surprising a lot of people. Yeah. They are working with a lot of momentum.
And GG.
Wow.
This is just over. Like,
what a game for Virtus.Pro. And this is considered
amazing play.
So I don't want to go too far here, but I feel like Radiant typically have advantages.
Yes.
Okay, they have the advantage over Dire.
The spell steal in the whole game, I think, is Global Silence. So
for sure.
Not expecting him to get that, but either Blink or something
like
that.
Getting the Nightmare out to... Arrow's going to completely miss. Misery's going to be the brunt of the damage here from the Wraith Fire Blast. The right clicks from Illidan. Probably not going to be enough. His NS is in a lot of trouble. Right clicks continuing. Piecat might get the last hit. He is. And now VP... All right, I'm in low likelihood to have to run away here. I'm not sure why they're being so aggressive. Jotam's going to go down as well, this time to Bane.
Yeah,
so big blunder here for VP. Getting over-aggressive.
I don't know if Chilling Touch was on cooldown or if he didn't have enough mana for... He must have had mana. He's used it once in this game. But they didn't use that until very, very late. And you're right. NS might
Wraith Fire Blast now on Piecat.
They're not
and
get
no
here.
Follow-up because... Well, actually, here we have Telekinesis Illidan taking some damage. NS has no mana to speak of. And again, this time Bane using the Brain Sap to finish him off.
And
this tri-lane's a disaster.
What's interesting about this is I would have favored VP's tri-lane because what Mouse has is that... Do you think Silencer with this build is going to buy more time than had he had like a Force Staff?
Well, we'll have to wait and see. Here's Dream Coil initiation from MSS. But there's the Global Silence. God's going to TP out, no problem. NS won't be so lucky. He doesn't have his ultimate to fall back on as MSS getting really low. But thankfully, his team knows how to aggro the tower. Boy, wish I had these teammates in pub games. I tell you what, they're going to be able to take this tier one tower. I think... So you're talking about the global, or I'm sorry, the Silencer going for Ags and hit harder at an early stage, I feel. I mean, that's the beauty of Mirana. The arrow sets up so much. As Fata going to get stunned from God. This is going to turn into 1v1 battle. Actually, we have some reinforcements on the way for both sides. Wraith Fire Blast to follow.
Oh,
arrow is going to hit God. Can they get the kill before Fata goes down? Oh, they kill each other simultaneously. Actually, Ancient Apparition getting credit for one of those kills. Is now VP on the run. Does Wraith King have his ult? Okay, he finally has his ult. His mid lane. Arsart. Oh, he's going to get Dream Coiled. This is the death of him. Brain Sap to finish him off. And Poss, is he level 6? Okay, so now we're getting some ults online. Rubick the last.
Scary late gamer, whereas you have heroes on DP like God, who's actually going to die.
Ult's going to hit too, but first they're going to clean up Dragonite, who is stuck trying to Ancient down some creeps. NS is going to get a stun off. It's going to finish off the Rubick, but he will fall in the end. Doesn't have his ult again because it's on cooldown still. And well, Mousesports just cleaning up. Rubick the only casualty here.
And now Global Silence is ready. Ancient Apparition with the ulti. They've got some good global presence. But Dragon Knight is just falling so far behind, and I think
And Nature's Prophet ult to follow.
Oh, Misery might... Oh, he's almost going to die from this, actually. Just these two ultimates.
Jeez.
He's down to 100 health. Here's going to be a mech for Maus, though. Fata has it. They're
going
to be okay, but... In the late game, it's important that Dragon Knight has enough items to be able to commit and start off the fight so these ultimates can hit, but right now he only has an Ogre Club. You would like to have a BKB at this point and even start working on your next item.
NS, he gets off the stun on Poss before the Nightmare can come out. Global Silence is here. Feel like it might be a little early because most of the Mouse's heroes are in their Ancients. They're going to avoid all fighting whatsoever here.
Arrow!
Alright. Well, God is going to get his stun off on Poss. Looks like he will find his death. AL not going to really hit. Dream Coil a follow though from MSS, and Piecat starts from doing massive amounts of damage. God at half HP, the right clicks to follow from MSS and company. He will go down. NS does get a stun off on Piecat though.
He might die here.
He leaps out.
Oh.
Should be good to go for now. Coldfeet actually going to proc on Rubick. Fata stuck in middle of three heroes, but it doesn't matter. The lower they get, the more damage he does. Arsart on the run. He will not get out thanks to the MSS blink, but only person to get out here is Wraith King. This should be a free Roshan, although... Piecat's not there, but I think they still take it. Oh, Telekinesis on NS. God is going to pop his ult. He's going to find Misery, but here comes Viper Strike. AL to follow. Global Silence. Rubick gets completely demolished. Fata, in the meantime, will go down to the right clicks as well. So a nice gank from Virtus.Pro overall. Here a Puck coming out. Arrow's going to connect. Oh my god, Jotam taking so much damage from the Bane Elemental. Piecat leaping out just in time. Is the buyback for Viper. They better get something out of this. VP might want to back up AA. Taking so much damage from Poss. That was a full duration Fiend's Grip. NS finally gets the stun off, but it's not enough to take out Poss, at least not yet. The damage over time is continuing. He's going to pop right back up. Illidan. Okay. MSS uses the newly picked up Cyclone Stick and helps finish him off. So a complete team wipe, so the buyback was definitely worth it for Viper. I'm not sure if anybody else bought back. Let's see. No, that's it.
Yeah.
So, wow. Team wipe.
PyCat could
buyback.
Play so aggressively because of the age.
First, there's the silence. They're going to pop BKB. At least Fata does, along with the Dragonite. No refresher yet. Saving it for whatever reason. Doesn't want to use it. I guess it's probably
Illidan's
the right
hexed.
Move here.
It's Fata already been used.
Getting slowed completely, but they don't have so much damage here. Look how much little damage God does. But the arrow's going to connect on God. But here comes NS doing more
second
damage
global.
Than God. AA ult to follow. Global ult as well from Silencer. And PyCat will use the Aegis. Will pop up very shortly.
He's dead.
Well, Nature's Prophet goes down to the Rubick, and here's the stun. PyCat gonna die again to VP. A 2-for-1 exchange right now. A beautiful dream call. Can he follow this up with anything else? And the answer
is he can follow it up with a blink
no.
out. Wow.
It's pretty, I don't want to say it's set. God is doing no damage. Holy jeez. Once
he's
he picks up that AC, that'll be
everything
good.
Everything he needs to do. He's frontlining. He's creating so damn, he's a hybrid.
Fortification. Yeah, okay. He's kind of like Wraith King in that regard, I guess. Like, kind of a hybrid overall. But tier 3 taking some damage from VP, but this might be a team fight actually. We have a stun on Poss. Just trying to create some space here. Arrow gonna. Oh, it's actually gonna hit Jot. I'm not sure if they want to jump in here. Here we go. MSS. Global Science is there. BKB by PyCat to follow. You're not hearing anything. Refresher. Did he pop it again? He did just now. Hey, oh, it's gonna completely whiff though. Puck dies, buys back immediately. PyCat continue to right click. Trying to kite as much as he can. NS is going to pop his ult. Thanks to the death, MSS is here, though, with a beautiful initiation again. Doing so much damage to Illidan, who pops his Ghost Scepter in the meantime. NS caught in the middle of nowhere, stuck in the base. Two dead for VP. Make it 3. Buybacks, though, for Mouse. That's 2 buybacks. Vayne is dead, so it's actually a 3-for-3. Okay, a 5-for-3. But 2 buybacks for Mouse. So I wouldn't say it's ridiculously in favor of them.
They're going to get Roche, though. That's the
That's
bigger
true.
Deal.
That is true.
I do not understand why... Why VP went for that play right then. Roche there is not. But if this tower falls, he actually will. He has gold for buyback now because of that kill. That could be really important.
Well, fortifications up.
AA does not have buyback though.
AA up in 25 seconds. They might just want to try to trade this.
Hex on Illidan. He's out of position.
Oh, no. Illidan. Why? Oh, why, Illidan? Does he have buyback?
He has buyback.
Okay, he has buyback and double ult to follow. Rax taking some damage. Some TP's out though. Poss.
Global?
Oh my god, they're actually going to get a Rax here top, at bottom I should say. I don't freaking believe this. Viper's going to pop his BKB, among other things. God, finally the ult's coming out from Silencer. Believe he hasn't popped his second one yet.
He has.
And
he's used
he
twice.
Okay,
yeah.
So he used both
ults. But if PyCat dies,
victory.
It doesn't matter and he will.
Wow.
Wow, no. He will not.
Oh,
wow.
A ult though, A-ult. Poss taking a lot of damage. A ult's going to hit.
This
not sure if that's going to be enough.
Not going to maybe be enough.
No, I don't think so.
Ooh, this is going to cut close. This is dealing a lot of damage per se. It will be enough.
You think so?
Yes, I think so. He needs to
like
drop. Yeah, he'll die. 1, 2.
And this one should do it.
3.
Oh!
Now, last tick.
That is so close. Poor PyCat.
Get
he dies
on my
a game.
I don't.
They're
going to
do just that.
Anyway. Yeah.
They're pushing mid.
We're like, going top is really good.
Oh, arrow's going to connect on the AA. Are they going to do anything about this? PyCat jumps in with his BKB, right clicking to his heart's intent.
Oh, Illidan
pops
ripped.
His ult and his refresher. NS. Blademail's actually doing decent amount of damage here, but PyCat ends up taking out Silencer. Does he have a buyback is the question. Rubick steals the Wraith Fire Blast. No surprise there. Misery going down to the right clicks of God. PyCat finally will die again. Double buyback from Mouse. Silencer's there. I believe he uses his Silencer ult
PyCat
as well.
Has buyback in 15 seconds.
God. Okay. Now things go silent.
Let's catch up. Buyback. Silencer. Viper. Bane.
Wow.
Rubick.
This is
Prophet. So 2-for-3.
Game of buybacks.
I think VP wins more out of that, but this is a really risky play.
Indeed. Blademail, good sir. He doesn't use it, and he
there
dies.
There we go, at 1%.
Well,
Dragon Knight, Arrow.
Oh boy, Arrow into God, set up by the Nightmare. Mjolnir is applied to him, dealing a little bit of damage, but the BKB is going to mitigate a lot of that for Fata as the right clicks continue, this time on Arsart, who's trying to take him out, but no. Triple kill for PyCat, who's dealing so much damage. Virtus Pro with 4 dead. I almost said Virtus Throw. Thank
AA
you.
They
Thank
have 3 buybacks. They're not. And if Poss gets hit, he's actually dead. Curse, not going to hit anything.
Arrow.
Oh god, this is a really tense moment for
nothing.
Both teams. Mao's going for it. Blink in from MSS.
Blink. Hex. Illidan taking the Dagon 1 damage. Not a whole lot to speak of. MSS on the run. Fortification's going to save the Rax, at least for now. The creeps. The illusion's what they really have to worry about. They're going to get the Rax, it looks like. Oh my god, yes. So Mao Sports evens it up as far as Rax are concerned. Whew, this game's intense, man.
Yeah, and they're not going back. They're going for the
oh
smoke.
Oh, my God. Here we
Illidan.
Go. Illidan getting caught out again. This could be it, ladies and gentlemen. Ailed. Nothing's going to come of it because he gets Fiend's Grip. 3 dead for Virtus Pro. Mouse continuing on the run here. God popped his BKB. They're going to go for bottom lane, Rax. They're taking it easy. They're taking it conservative, I guess is the best way to put it. NS gets a stun off on Piecat. I don't think he can defend this.
Misery!
Oh my god, Bane gets destroyed!
And now Piecat
in the meantime! Wraith King and God together, defending bot lane. I don't believe it. A nice Yule's gonna
Dragon
dodge
Tail's
the stun.
Ready. Oh boy, he
Faith
will silence
shift,
first, I
Blaine
think. Oh, he gets Tails!
Gets the stun off, MSS goes down. Defense successful.
11
for
viewers have received a prize. World record. Tier 4s have dropped.
Oh my god. Okay, so next time Virtus Pro pushes, they don't go for Rax, they go for GG. And
but
I
it's,
think.
Oh my.
How many.
If they want to buy back. I think they're going to have to. The mid barracks are just going to fall. This tower has one hit in HP.
Okay, they might actually go for Rax since the tier 3
is
down.
Oh boy. Illidan is out in 15 with double ulti. He can do a lot from across the map.
Absolutely. He's up in 12 seconds, as you talked about. This Rax is dead. Arrow's going to hit NS. He has his ulti. He'll be back regardless of
the
fact.
Buy back from the puck.
These illusions are destroying these Rax. So mid Rax down completely. Piecat's getting destroyed, my god! Finally, the force staff comes out, or whatever
Global.
God that was. AL to follow. Not
MSS
sure
is down
did
again.
Did it hit Morana? I'm not sure. Fata pops his BKB on the run, actually teeping out in his own base. That's never a good
He's
sign.
Stunned.
The stun! Fata, this might be GG for Virtus Pro now! They're gonna continue here. Nature's Prophet's here. Silencer, pop the ult already. Morana and Bane, the last to survive. GG's come out. Virtus Pro. What am I watching? I don't understand Dota anymore. What? I don't understand it.
What a.
I'm gonna ban that. There's your.
Everyone
that's the Nakes bomb right there, is Quap. So it
Everyone
looks like Silencer will be the support.
We will have a remake. I'm not sure who is out.
Oh,
is
here we go. Ventral
Spear
going
to
start off with a stun if you can get it up. There we go. And double TP. They're going to be forced back here. Not going to get the kill. But this is going to force
King
out a lot.
Burrow reach.
Strike's going to hit. And Troll with his slow auto attacks with that Chilling Touch are going to deal so much damage. A Blink Dagger at 6 minutes and 30 seconds on Slark as he gets a kill on Nature's Prophet.
Arsard was not expecting that one.
That
nice
is so
by,
fast.
By
I know his chains between his legs, I guess. But he's actually going to get grouped up by Vengeful Spirit, among others. Fata, Open Wounds is there to start. Ault is going to hit three, though. Arsard is also there. Fata getting completely destroyed as the Sonic Wave finishes him off. Possum, in the meantime, getting chased by Illidan. He's going to try to TP out. This should be enough
nice
damage.
Swap.
The swap's going to ensure the victory. Actually, Slark helping kill the troll. And there's
oh, there's nothing to
misery.
Invest into.
Illidan. Oh, Arsard.
He's like, Arsard, help.
And this might cause his death as well, although he did not get the leap initially there. The pounce, I should say. Shadow Strike now on Misery. Piecat's going to continue the pursuit. And yes, is enough to kill
oh,
him.
Oh, Piecat with
wow,
the clutch
even
ult.
Even the lasso being used here. Ultra kill for Piecat so early in the game. This is like the last hero you want to get four kills on early stage. Piecat playing the Slark.
Wow.
Thought he might go deep there, but not too greedy. Like, not too far in the future. And that's the main reason. I shouldn't say it's the main reason for getting Global Silence, but your initiation is still going to be
Piecat.
Jotam. Getting caught out thanks to Piecat. AL to follow. Is it going to hit? Yes! Blows him up as a result. There's the Infest Bomb onto Fata. He pops his mech and is just going to TP out. Is there enough to take him out beforehand? Nope! 11-2 advantage for Mouse. They're getting everything they want right now. Piecat is still here. He's still here! And there's the lasso initiation on God. This game is just getting out of control. Burrow Strike to follow. Illidan goes down 13-2. Mouse Sports. This is going to be so hard to come back as Piecat just adding insult to injury, a triple kill on top of an ultra kill from not too long ago.
All right, that Blink Dagger is actually pretty good.
It's pretty damn good, as they are up by a lot in the net worth chart.
And if he even catches on the TP,
yeah,
they'll give this tower
either.
Away.
MSS,
or will they? MSS.
Blink, lasso onto Illidan, who doesn't pop Rage in time. Is there any follow-up damage?
I
not
got it
really.
Now.
Burrow Strike is there, but not going to hit thanks to the Rage. And Misery, Sentry being put down. And the right clicks continue, and Misery's gonna go down. So two down in Virtus Pro's favor, but wow, Troll actually getting a kill. How often do you see somebody getting a kill with that, for God's sake?
Did he got
two for one.
With the ranged?
Yeah, for
ranged
the ranged whirling axes. It does like 75 damage. It's like nothing. It's
Virtus
worse
Pro.
Than the Wave of Terror. Along with Piecat's initiation, Jotam in all likelihood will go down. And indeed he does. Drums actually pop for Fata to help get their team out, and the tier two should be pretty easy kill.
Now Global is ready.
Yeah, but so is Lasso. And there it comes onto God, the Burrow Strike to follow. So much damage coming their way. NS just got to run away. And now this tier 2 should be dead. Actually, AA goes down to Illidan. Where is he going to go? He infests into an enemy creep.
They might try to turn and fight this if Queen of Pain buys. No, no buyback. But Illidan chose a really good creep here.
Yes, indeed. It's going to be
he's
the last
stay
good
alive.
Kill.
Very nicely done. So he will live, but another tower going Mouse's way. They're taking more and more control of the map, being very effective and very aggressive, not giving VP any sort of chance to just. Virtus Pro seem nervous about this.
They should.
They have no idea who's here. They actually could have taken the tower, but.
Oh, I don't blame them, though.
Oh, AA ult, gonna whiff.
gonna whiff it.
Jumping into Queen of Pain, we might see a goal here.
Oh, Blink, Infest Bomb, Fata. There's the Global Science to follow.
Oh, MSS went in.
MSS uses the lasso on the Rage Illidan. They're gonna clean up boss
well.
Now. The right clicks continue. NS taking a lot of damage. There's the Epicenter being used. The Burrow Strike to follow is enough to take Gods out. Oh, he's gonna blink. He's okay for now. He has an Oblivion Step, so going for an Orchid Pycat on the run. Using his Dark Pack to debuff a little bit of that action here.
Nope.
As he is silenced again, Urn Charge. He's going to pop it again, though.
Pycat being chased
and
down here.
He has his Blink in 1 second. He should be okay.
Virtus Pro still got a 3-for-1, right?
Yes.
3-for-1 plus tower. Still in it.
Pycat. Yeah, that was a very good turnaround. A wraparound.
Oh, Illidan is really far out of position here. He's stuck around.
Well, not a whole lot of stats are stolen from Pycat right now, so Illidan's fine with that Rage. Misery.
Is he, though?
Looking for the Blink Burrow Strike. Illidan.
Oh, big play.
Big play.
That was actually a pretty big play. I think he would have died if he went the obvious way there.
Well, he had the swap available still. Oh, Jot him.
Jot him, got him.
Won't get you out of this. Illidan pops the Rage, right clicks on Misery. They will trade 1-for-1. Pycat's going to blink out.
I don't think that's a good trade.
Fata.
Yep.
Looking for somebody. The AL's going to miss. He's actually going to initiate on in. MSS is going to initiate, though, on the other side of the forest. Onto Illidan. Not going to find what he wants. He's just going to get destroyed. He's not careful. Jot him in the meantime, taking the right clicks. Nice swap out. Might be enough for him to get away.
Slick moves,
yep.
But...
here comes Quap. Not enough to save his comrade in arms, but the Sonic Wave is there to help take down Fata, although he's going to TP out. Not enough damage, actually. So Pycat on the run. AA and Illidan attempting to catch up.
Really,
but,
really
alas,
nice hit and run play from Mouse here.
That's their whole lineup. That's what they're based off of, just all hit and runs.
That was very, very nice. They were down 4 against 5. They still
push
lane. Are they going to go for it? Oh, yes, they are.
Burrow Strike is there. Illidan taking the brunt of the damage. He pops his Rage finally, but
good,
it's not going to matter. Oh, there's a swap. Beautifully done. Jotam's going to trade his life, and the vengeful aura, whatever you want to call it, is actually being applied here. Illidan, the Aegis is used. God pops his BKB and blinks out.
Can he does not have Rage.
Teammate? Can they save their teammate? Illidan goes down so quickly. Global Silence a little bit too late.
There's no buyback. And I think NS might die as well.
Oh. NS barely lives as he TPs back, and this push should continue.
This is a lane
now.
Of Rax. Troll ult,
of
in
course.
10 seconds.
It's always up. It's always up, laddie. Okay? Always up.
There was a couple of interpretations for that one. I'm going to stay with the good one.
I didn't mean to have that accent. It just came. He can't buy back with the free racks. I think Virtus Pro just gives this up. Don't even try here. You don't want to lose anybody else on the back end.
Thinking about it, actually might hold.
Are you kidding me? 30 seconds.
Tanking goes in.
Oh, double Burrow Strike. Ails to come, but a nice swap from Jotam. He will find his end again. To the grave he goes. And NS is going to get completely destroyed by Pycat. In fact, he's going to clean up more on top of that. Buyback for Vengeful Spirit. Nature's Prophet. It's not going to be enough. This should be a free rack. I feel like they shouldn't have. They should just give this up. They should have given it up without any casualties.
And the whole thing that started this out was Lifestealer was out of position out here, which is okay. He had the Aegis. It could have been a bait. But Venge was so damn.
Who are they going to find here? It's going to be Pycat. Global Silence is there. But Pycat pops his ultimate. He's going to be fine. In fact, he's just going to right click using the Abyssal Blade on Illidan. And he's going to get cleaned up completely. Epicenter to follow. And this is an absolute disaster for God and company, as this is probably GG. So Mousesports, surprisingly, it takes them 2 games to finally get a victory. Or the 3rd game, I should say. So it's 2-1 advantage still for Virtus Pro. Mouse have their backs to the wall. They came through.
They're going
to
go for it this time around. And the reasoning for Virtus Pro here, I think, is that there's a...
Heed,
that's
God.
Real bad, guys.
That's real bad. Gets off a really nice
zero damage ult.
Well, the sanity clip didn't do a whole lot. Actually, Pycat's going to find OD. This is going to be a big kill coming his way if he's able to finish him off.
Oh,
one
he's
more
not.
Right click.
3 HP.
One more right click, Pycat. You can do it, bro.
He needs to hit the pounce.
2 seconds on pounce. He could dodge this.
Oh!
I've never seen anything like that before. That was interesting.
He's out of mana, though.
Yeah, Arsart actually cancels the health pot right away, but Pycat
can't get him. Oh, my God.
Fast. Pounce Astral. That's scary. You can pounce Astral. Pretty cool.
Damn, that was so close.
He can
God.
Get a Blink Dagger right now, too, so yeah. Expect to get out just fine.
Will
Jot
they salvage
anytime.
Their bottom tower?
Leech Seed applied to Misery. He has the Black Hole. I'm not sure if he wants to use it here. It would be a pretty big waste overall. NS getting absolutely demolished.
He got mana burned.
Oh, my God, he did. NS in the meantime. I'm sorry. Enigma in the meantime gets Astral in prison. They're just going to leave him.
So one-for-one tower trade, but Wraith King did go down. Very nice.
And typically speaking,
here.
We talk about it all the time. The mana
Aegis, though.
He does have the Aegis, like you said. Impale's only going to hit one. Overgrowth to follow. MS is going to be the target of choice here. NS getting Astral in prison along with the Living Armor. He might be in a little bit of trouble. I'm sure the Malphus will follow very shortly. There it is.
He has
easy
enough sticks.
Kill.
He didn't use it.
Oh, wow, you're right. You are absolutely right. Illidan again in a horrible spot. Illidan. What? Is he nature guys?
Oh, my
he's nature
God.
Guys. Oh, my God. He's panicking. They're going to find Jotam, but I think they'll trade that any day of the week.
Oh,
as long as Drop
God,
can get Pass out.
Oh, will find him. Oh.
No, Illidan. Illidan, run, please. Gust is there. Oh, I wish he... Oh, Sunstrike. Oh, that is truly unfortunate for Illidan. I don't know what in God's name he was doing in that position, but it didn't work out for him, obviously. Yeah. And free tier one. Yeah.
So the Necrobook cannot remove her aura by just...
Wraith King's going to find MSS, or maybe the other way around. Nice silence on MSS, but oh my god. NS has no mana. Okay, he does.
Used the wand well.
Wand at the last second. Jotam. Is he able to get off his overgrowth? He is. Black Hole. It is on OD. That's really all that matters. Is Drow is just right-clicking from the other side of the Black Hole. They haven't killed anybody else on the tree.
Oh, Misery's going to live with 20 HP.
NS is still alive, thanks to that ult. And God trying to get out of dodge, but it's not going to do so, thanks to the Blink Dagger on MSS. 3 dead in favor of Mouse Sports. They're starting to run away. Illidan is just so squishy. What does he have right now? Should have a Mantis Eye very short. Oh, boy. Sunstrike's going to miss. Can they stop the TP? No.
Very nice Gust. Hit the Nyx so he
can
inhale.
Oh, boy. Yeah, I don't think it's
going to live.
It's going to be. Oh, here we go. Gust is there along with the Ice Wall. Fata dealing a little bit of damage, but the Ice Wall is keeping everybody in place. Illidan on the run. He's at half HP. The drum's being popped by Pycat. Oh, he's actually going to get stuck. The beautiful pounce, though, to finish off Illidan in all likelihood. Manta. Okay, Illidan is somehow still alive, but three are dead for Virtus Pro, so doesn't really matter a whole lot, as this is just getting out of hand now. Is it going to find another pounce target? AA is dead. Complete team wipe with very little damage done overall to Mouse.
From a greed standpoint, it made a lot of sense to pick the Drow, because they knew they had a free lane of farm. I just don't think this is a Drow game. Like, Slothro would have gone for a different greedy carry that could have fought a lot more, that could have worked.
Goodbye, good sir. He has his ult. He'll be back in a second. Slow is ridiculously high AoE. My goodness. He's going to get the right fire bass on Fata. This is going to be the last stand for VP. There is Enigma trying to get off the black hole, but not in time.
It's over.
Still has it available. But
God's
going
to die.
One last right click to Pycat. Malphite now on Illidan. You are probably not going to get out of this. A nice impale from the low ground. There's the black hole. Not the PGG one that we love so very much. And this is going to be GG in all likelihood. NS will be the last target, unless Pycat wants to go really deep, but the GG's finally come out. So this is now tied 2-2 in the grand finals. We're going to a deciding game 5. And this game was not very clear.
Stampede, which can help him. So there's a lot of options to play aggressively here. And the combo he has with his
is probably a good thing, because the reinforcements are on the way for Mouse Sports.
Jotam.
Oh, boy.
Jotam.
Illidan's going to get a double Chronosphere. Flamebreak is in there. Sunstrike. Wow, Illidan just gets the hell out of there. Jotam in the meantime. Probably going to go down. Actually, initiation again, this time on Illidan. Taking a little bit of damage, but he does finally go down the right clicks of Nature's Prophet. NS in the meantime. Dead as well. So MSS doing a really good job of showing up for these fights. I hate seeing Weavers that don't take part in early fights. Flamebreak is hilarious.
They were 100 gold off a Blink Dagger on Centaur. Invoker was not in the lane. Away with it, and Virtus Pro wouldn't be able to respond. Virtus Pro just did so well in the first two games that you would have thought they could carry it over, but the previous two games as well as this one, they're just getting utterly dominated by Miles, and we're going to see an initiation again.
Oh, Burrow Strike is there, though. Illidan, so much trouble, good sir. Fata will get cleaned up, thankfully, thanks to the Sunstrike and the other things, Batrider and Void trade lives, though. And Arsart is next, and the other AA is dead. Oh boy, Mouse Sports. All they lose is the Batrider, who got an amazing initiation. Actually, it was decent counter initiation from VP, but it just didn't work out. It's triple center to follow with the Burrow Strike. It's way too much damage for VP. NS might actually get an out glimpse. Oh, that's so sad. Look at him. That's the saddest ancient apparition I've ever seen. Glimpse so strong. 11-1 in Mouse Sports' favor.
Are Virtus Pro seriously trying for...
And even that's not guaranteed. We have so many TPs here. Burrow Strike on Jotam. Finally gets off an overgrowth. He's just going to fall very shortly after. MSS with the BKB could time-lapse if he chooses. Okay, he didn't use time-lapse. Interesting choice with that BKB activated. It's a 1-for-2 exchange right now. Another Burrow Strike, this time on Arsart, who has 2 stacks of sticky napalm. Faith, Fada. Okay, Void finally going to get... Wow, that's exactly what we talked about all game. The glimpse is going to get him completely out of the picture. It's going to save the life of Nature's Prophet. And VP just has to back up. Here's a beautiful double Burrow Strike. Flame break is going to finish off the Invoker Illidan. He goes in. I'm not sure why. He might be in a lot of trouble. In fact, he might actually
gets
get a kill.
Bash.
All right, he gets a kill. So, I don't
know. Pro needs to get more. They need to get a collateral here if they can.
TP,
but that was actually not too bad for him. And again, this is the classic. It seems to be the
Tower or Roche. Roche is, by the way, up now. This is the perfect timing for the BKB for Illidan. Can Virtus Pro get the initiation, or will Mouse just
We have an aggressive
over?
Smoke here, initiation again. Chronosphere, beautifully done. AL to follow, along with the Sunstrike. Misery and Fata get blown up completely. A 3v5 situation for Virtus Pro as Illidan's getting quite low to the right clicks. Oh my god, MSS absolutely decimated him. Jotam and company are forced out, and that's going to TP out. Is it going to be enough? Yes.
Oh, Pika didn't hex.
And Jotam will get out just in time. So it's a 2-for-1. Batrider Sand King for a Void. Of course, the BKB doesn't really help you against Weaver, who is hitting like a truck at this point.
Yeah, nice chrono here from
Living Armor that mid tower, so you never know.
That's
Maybe
true.
He forgets about it.
Oh, I can heal towers?
There's the Veil of Discord on
Sand King. Batrider on the hunt.
Indeed. Who's he looking for? He's going to initiate onto Centaur. Do they have enough damage to take him out before the Stampede's used? He's a little chicken or a pig, whatever you want to call him. He's going to run down as Illidan, using his ult, along with Ancient Apparition, to take out Sand King. Arsart and company. Jotam's really low here. Void's getting really deep. There's a Static Storm used to zone him completely out of the river. Deafening Blast using MSS, as he's actually stuck in a pretty hard spot. Nice Hoof Stomp. Of course, he has Aegis. He has so many lives, as you talked about. Gonna use his Time Lapse, though. Killing Jotam in the meantime. Arsart, you are stuck in between so many Necro units. And here's the blink
from
Fata.
5 seconds. He will probably get glimpsed here.
Well,
Paz is really far back, actually. He will not catch up. So Illidan does get out of here.
Glimpse has ridiculous range, keep in mind. Oh my god, that Flame Break is beautiful! Sunstrike is not going to hit, though.
It was also on his own team.
What? Oh, damn it! I did it again! These arrows and Sunstrikes, I swear to god.
Arsart! He stayed way too
glimpse.
Long!
The Glimpse is there. So reserved for Arsart. Yeah, he was there for quite a while. And we'll fall to the Weaver.
So again, Virtus Pro, they got a free kill, right? They went in.
Does he have enough for buyback on the
A-Ult?
A-Ult is going to hit a few. There's the Chronosphere on Pycat, and Pycat alone. Do they have enough damage to actually finish him off? Fata doing a nice job of zoning out Invoker completely. In fact, he might actually die to the right clicks. Oh, beautiful. Ghost Walk in the last second. Oh, no. He does die. Okay, he does have buyback along with the Boots of Travel. Hoofstomp's going to miss Misery. There's the Epicenter and the Veil of Discord a little bit late, but Arsart taking quite a bit of damage. Batrider in the meantime getting out of dodge. MSS. I hear a Sunstrike.
Illidan
glimpse. Not to kill anybody though. Glimpse onto Illidan. He goes down. Does he have a buyback? Even if he does, he doesn't really do that much right now. This is a tier 3, if not more. This is 4 for... Did anybody buyback? Did anybody die from Mouseports? I don't think so. So this is a 4 for nothing. And the buyback was forced from Invoker. So big time team fight win for Mouseports, as they might even take 2 racks without a Void for 45 seconds.
This is what happens when this one, not the guy you want to go on, is your last priority target together with Weaver. Mm-hmm. But those are the two that Mouse will frontline with. They did the perfect positioning in this situation.
Oh boy, they're going for 3.
Oh boy.
Oh boy. Last, as I said, at the same time as you, Misery and company taking out Ancient After. Buyback from Void, so I guess he just had enough money now.
No,
and this
he
is gonna
just
force,
waiting.
He's waiting this whole time? Fata? Gets Chronosphered, Veil of Discord on Illidan. He's gonna pop the BKB. Doesn't even have enough to kill the Batrider here. Overgrowth is there. Jotam taking quite a bit of damage. MSS in the meantime. We'll get the kill. A beautiful time lapse. Actually, no, it wasn't. He time lapsed into the Hoofstomp, into a Sunstrike, and whatnot.
It's all Ogre,
but
guys.
But everybody's dead. GG's will come out very shortly. Why didn't he buy back? Did I miss something? Why did he buy back after the second rack?
He thought he
down?
Wouldn't have to. He thought he needed the gold. And then at the end, he was like, okay, I have to buy back.
How much time did he buy back with?